Hi, folks. Welcome to Handy Randy. We're going to take you to school today on the Handy Randy Show, talking about NAPA and NAPA products. You may or may not have heard me brag about NAPA batteries before, and rightly so, because NAPA batteries were rated number one in the world by Consumers Digest. And someone that really knows even more about batteries than Handy Randy, Tom Hubbard. Welcome to the show, Tom.
Thanks, Randy. Glad to be here.
And Tom represents NAPA batteries to the NAPA stores. NAPA is very unique in the automotive parts industry because everyone else has gotten rid of reps like you.
Correct.
They just, yes. It's a way to save some money. They go to the manufacturer, pound the manufacturer on better price, and they say, finally, they say, you know what? We've cut everything we can. We're making the product as cheap as we can make it now. So now we're going to get rid of the reps. And that's what the competition has done.
Yes, you're right.
They have no one like you out there, except NAPA.
Except NAPA, and that's correct. And NAPA has a lot of faith and a lot of trust and a lot of interest in the factory reps, simply because we bring to the table any issues or concerns that the jobber store might have, or the individual dealer, or in some cases, the consumer. You can't be something to everybody. You know, they might call an ops manager or someone at customer service for some help in my line, batteries, alternators, and starters. And sometimes these folks, you know, with over 1,000 lines, may not be able to answer the question correctly. So NAPA relies a lot heavily on our factory reps, and we have 10 groups in the NAPA family. I do, like I said, the alternator starters and batteries. We have folks that do brakes. We have folks that do belts and hoses. We have folks that do under car, which would be like spark plugs, wires, things like that. So we're focused on our products. We know how they work, and should there be an issue, NAPA or the consumer comes to us and gets answers to to those particular questions, and we usually do that in a satisfactory manner.
Batteries, there's an example. Let's say that I'm either a technician, a shop owner, or a parts sales professional that works in a store. For me in one of the competitors' situations, for me to gain knowledge on the product that I sell, I'd pretty much have to do it myself at the competition. I'd have to go online or read books, magazines, so forth, to find out about this product. This is the NAPA Legend battery.
Yes.
But NAPA, it's different because we have you to come into the stores to meet with our installers to tell them about features, advantages, and benefits. I'm going to tell you the little bit that I know about the NAPA Legend battery. Firstly, it's built in Pennsylvania.
Correct.
The only thing better than being built in Pennsylvania would be built in Ohio. But we'll take Pennsylvania. And I was kidding, Tom, about Pennsylvania. Some people think Pennsylvania is kind of a strange place. Especially when you get Tom Hubbard, he's from Pennsylvania.
No, it's not strange.
but other than Ohio, it's a heck of a lot better than Michigan, Pennsylvania is. Here's a product that we can be proud of because so many of the competitors out there can't claim that a battery is built even in the United States. They can't make that claim.
That's true. A lot of our competition and Randy mentioned about Consumer Reports, and that was a huge plus to NAPA because they did rank this battery right here as the number one best cold starting and hot starting battery, simply because it has ample cold cranking amps to get the job done. And Randy mentioned about the NAPA product and made it by East Penn and Lion Station, Pennsylvania. They handle pretty much all of the NAPA, among other customers that they have, east of the Mississippi. West of the Mississippi is another manufacturer that handles the NAPA product out that way.
And that's distribution. It's difficult to ship batteries because they're so heavy.
Sure. And production, that comes into a play also. East Penn isn't geared up to do, they do almost a 800,000 to 900,000 batteries a month, which is enough to handle NAPA plus their other outlets that they service. Plus, they have not only do that many batteries per month, but they have a unique feature and benefits to their batteries. And the number one is, I wanted to just to show you, you can see the first thing that we talk about that's different for NAPA compared to our competition is all of our batteries are flat top. You can see here, this is just going to be a cutaway of a battery that is flat on the top of it. I don't know if you can see this one, but this is a real battery. It's all flat top. That means it's maintenance free. So this is the type of battery that a consumer can buy, get it installed by a garage or an installer, and they can forget about the battery. Our competition may have, you might remember seeing gang caps on the top of it where they're there for a reason, because that battery gases, loses water. So over time, a year or two, you have to replace that water simply because it evaporates. So if this battery is in the trunk, which many batteries are in trunks, in the back seat of cars, even in the fender wells,
buried in the engine compartment where you don't even see it.
And if you can get this box in the engine compartment, yes, it's usually buried. It's not like a pickup truck, one of the older pickup trucks. You open up the hood and bang, there's your battery right there in front of you. Easily accessible for maintenance, which you have to do, except for our NAPA batteries, which I call it, you install it and forget it.
So Tom mentioned about the quality of this battery, and before we go to our first break, you told me about a trial that a person did. When I work in a parts store, and I know, I don't work in a parts store, I show up at a parts store, I have gotten to a habit of when I'm selling a battery, I will show the customer how the battery is rated. And basically in our area, we want to know what the cold cranking amps are, because we live in a cold climate. About in Ohio this year, about 9 months out of the year, we live in a cold climate. That cranking amp is awfully important. This one happens to be rated at 875 cold cranking amps. And they're proud of it. They're not hiding anything. Some batteries won't tell you what they are. It's plastered right on the top of the battery. 875 cold cranking amps. Now there's a tester, it's called a Midtronic tester, which is a wonderful tester. I get out, I hook it up to the battery, and I show the consumer, say, you know what, this battery is rated at 875, but about 9 out of 10 times I'm going to say that the rating of 875 isn't even near what this battery really is. It's way over 1,000, sometimes 1,100 cold cranking amps at 875. So, and I'll put that challenge up to any of you out there to stop in at a NAPA store and say, I saw this promise on the Handy Randy show. Why don't you show me any battery? I don't care what it is. Grab that off the shelf, put that tester on it. It only takes a couple minutes, and you will see that they underrate their batteries. Where most people would overrate their batteries, they underrate their batteries. So you're getting much more of a bang for your buck. So we're going to go to a commercial, probably a NAPA commercial, and because NAPA is a big sponsor of the Handy Randy Show. When we come back, we're going to show you the inside of this NAPA Legend battery. Don't touch the remote. Handy Randy with Tom Hubbard. He's the battery expert, but it's more than batteries, because you do starters and alternators and battery cables and wire connectors and all kind of stuff like that, don't you, Tom?
Well, except for the wire cables and connectors, yes. I mean, you would think that would go with my line. A guy that sells batteries should be selling the accessories like battery cables, maybe even chargers, but that falls under
somebody else,
other
gets
group.
The gravy stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
I was mentioning about the test that a fella did up in on Lake Buffalo. Erie somewhere, right?
Correct, in Buffalo. Yeah, Randy was mentioning about the coal cranking amps, how NAPA has under, or East Penn NAPA has underrated the coal cranking amps. And a perfect example of this would be, of course, like Randy said, you can put the Medtronic's tester on a battery to get amperage and volts, and you could see the difference between what's printed on the plaque of the battery and also what comes up in the machine. But there was a fella up in electrical sales group like myself up in Buffalo, New York in February. Remember when we had that polar vortex and it was, oh, I know, it was a miserable cold winter. And actually, it was a very good winter for battery sales because any marginal battery that survived the summer was deeply hurt by the cold winter, and cold and heat are what really puts batteries through, it's the test. But what this fella did is he took one of our competitor batteries and the NAPA battery, equivalent battery, and both were rated at 950 coal cranking amps, and he put them outside at 5 degrees above zero. He put it outside and had a thermometer, those laser thermometers, to keep record of the temperature every 2 hours. Plus he had his Medtronic's tester to get the amp reading on the battery every 2 hours. When he first put them outside, the competitor's battery, like I said, was rated at 950, came in at 1,000. The NAPA battery was around 1,100 coal cranking amps. Every 2 hours he came back, and the competitor's battery was dropping by 10%. The NAPA battery was dropping by about 2%. So he did that for 8 hours, just as if you came home from work, you parked your car in your driveway, and went to bed at night, but get up in the next morning, that would be about 8-9 hours later. And when he did the test 9 hours later, the competitor's battery at 950 original coal cranking amps was down to 625 coal cranking amps. The NAPA battery was at 1,000 even. So the competitor's battery lost almost half of its coal cranking amps. Will that start a battery in cold weather with an engine below freezing at five degrees out there, with the thick oil and the sludge that's in that engine?
That was a brand spanking new battery.
Correct. Both were brand new. They had the same ship code dates on the battery, and it was absolutely amazing that our competitor's battery was that low, and the NAPA battery was even above, after 8 hours in the cold, above the 950 coal cranking amps.
That's why we're so proud of this product, okay? Again, it's made right here in our own neighborhood. That means American workers working, getting paid, banking in America, buying in America, unlike the competition, which may be coming from China.
Mm-hmm, yes.
A lot of batteries made in Korea. Not knocking the Koreans, they're our allies, but even in Mexico, a whole slew of the competition batteries are made in Mexico. These are made in Pennsylvania, and Pennsylvania is at least a step up from China.
Yes, I certainly gotcha. believe it is. Yeah.
Now, Tom, tell us about the inside of this battery. We look at the outside, maintenance-free, very attractive battery, but the inside is what really makes the difference. Tell us about these.
Correct. This battery is what we call a flooded lead acid battery. We have to add acid at the factory to get this battery to work. On the left hand side here, you have an example of a negative plate. On this side here, you have an example of a positive plate. And these are all wrapped in an envelope. But the most important thing I want to point out at this point is how those grids, positive and negative, is designed. NAPA has, or East Penn has, come up with a design that if you can follow the grids, those little web-like type of lines, they all go to what we call the post. So You know the old saying, a shortest distance between any two places is a straight line? Well, that's what East Penn has done, is they want to get that surge when you turn your key and that surge of amperage flows out of the battery to the starter. We want that path to be as short as possible to get the maximum amps flow into the starter.
And the competition is pretty much square.
The competition is up and down like a box, and it's and the travel from the bottom of that grid has to go across and up and over, whereas ours is on an angle that gives you that power when you need it.
And something as simple as that, and then of course the amount of plates in a battery also are important. And another thing about plates in a battery, I've seen some of the plates are short in competition. Well, they'll say, well, boy, they've got 8 plates or 11 plates per cell, but they're only half the size of these plates.
That's correct, yeah. Plates, the thickness of a plate has a lot of impact on cold cranking amps and now reserve capacity. Back in our day when we had a 1975 Chevy Monte Carlo with a 350 motor in it or 400, we wanted at that time 1,000 cold cranking amp. Remember that?
Yeah,
I want 1,000 cold cranking amps. Well, back then, a car may have needed that because of maybe all the gearheads, a high compression engine, rebuilt the motor so it's got higher compression, and a cold cranking amp was needed at that point. But in today's engines, the compression isn't as high in those days. Plus, you have so many other accessories running. Everything from every memory you can think of that needs to be saved. Sometimes it's in the, I don't have it at my cars, but they have seat positions. You punch in a number and you set your seat for a certain position. That's all memory saved. You've got clock, radio, you've got Bluetooth now. You've got so many running items that a cold cranking amp battery does not have the reserve capacity. It's a trade-off. If you want amps, you get amps. Or cold cranking amps. If you want reserve capacity, you take away a little bit of the cold cranking amps to get reserve capacity. So all the NAPA batteries now are in the 700-800 cold cranking amp range, which is fine. But most importantly, in today's vehicles, the reserve capacity comes into play, and our batteries took away some of the cold cranking amps, but they also have plenty of that
because
reserve.
Of the electronics. In a modern automobile, as many as 15 computers on your car, as Tom mentioned, all of those things that drain the battery. And believe me, if you don't start with 12.6 and stay with 12.6, your car might have drivability issues. I'll give you one old story. This goes back a few years in the Andy Randy life. As a fellow with a Cavalier that had spent over $1,500 trying to get his vehicle to run properly. And he had taken it to this shop, to the next shop, and it had new injectors put on it, a new computer put on it, new pickups put on it, all of these wires, plugs, all these things, and finally took it to an old-time, old-school mechanic, and he says, did anybody check the voltage on the battery? And what happened was, is this battery started off with something less than 12.8 volts. Mm-hmm. And by the time it got to those components, it had lost a couple volts, and $1,500 of repair wasted because the car should have had a new battery. Should have had a new battery. So any car in our area, in our Ohio area, if the battery is more than 4 or 5 years old, as you mentioned before, cycles, cold weather, hot weather, it's probably due to be replaced. Not possibly, probably due to be replaced because of the climate we live in. We're going to go to a break. When we come back, Tom has more than just batteries to tell you about right here on the Handy Randy Show. Hope you're enjoying. Welcome back. I warned you. I said we're going to talk to Tom Hubbard from Pennsylvania. I warned you. So No, I'm just kidding. He's an expert when it comes to starters, alternators, batteries. That's why I invited him in on the show, because it's pretty obvious I don't know it all, and I don't claim to know it all. So that's why I bring in the experts. Tom, we have a wonderful product at the NAPA stores. It's the NAPA Power Premium Plus alternators and starters. Actually, NAPA gives the consumer some choices. They don't force one thing on you. There's several choices. If I need an alternator for my Chrysler Town and Country van, the NAPA store will say, hey, I can give you this, this, or this. Tell us about that.
Correct. Thank you. Yep. NAPA alternators and starters are manufactured by BBB out of Chicago and Texas. And they have distribution centers throughout the whole United States servicing all of NAPA. They do a real nice job of remanufacturing and selling new product. This Premium Power Plus happens to be the most popular alternator and starter that NAPA sells by far, compared to the premium line, which would be like a lifetime warranty. It's all remanufactured pretty much with new components. And then we also have a new alternator and starter line. Brand new, it fits the OE specifications. There's no remanufacturing in it. So for your Town and Country car, if you wanted an exact replacement of that factory alternator or starter, you could go to NAPA and say, I want the factory new alternator or starter put back into my vehicle. I've had huge success with it for 10 years, no issues. I want to go that route.
Limited lifetime warranty as well.
It is, yes.
Which I can't get from the dealer.
From the dealer. No. This is lifetime warranty. The new product and our premium remanufactured product is lifetime, with towing service available also. Should the customer purchase a NAPA premium alternator starter or a new alternator and starter, in the box, the installer should give them a card they fill out, send it in to it's ERS, Emergency Roadside Service, is who we use, and the customer gets a PIN back. And for 5 years, should they be shopping during the Christmas holidays and they forget to leave their lights on, they go to a mall and forget about the lights, go in, come back 3 or 4 hours later, and they get in their car and the car won't start. They have no idea why it won't start. They could call that PIN number or that number on that PIN card, and a dispatcher, similar to AAA, would come out, diagnose the issue, find the battery was just discharged because of the lights, and jumpstart the car, probably in most cases, to get that customer going at no charge.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Now,
so
talk about what goes in. There are. Again, I want to talk about the competition. Mm-hmm. And usually the competition is all about price. It's all about price. I've been in the business for a long, long time, and I've been in a position where I've been a buyer, and I've talked to some folks that supply parts and pieces. A guy told me one time that he was in a factory that when the older the cores to be rebuilt would come into the factory, they would first clean them up and test them. If the thing tested good, because it was just had dirt corrosion on the terminals, they would clean that up, spray paint it, put it in a box, and send it out as rebuilt. True story. Mostly on starters, not on alternators. True story. So obviously they were able to sell that product for a very low price, very competitive price. It was used with paint on it. True story. So there's a wide spectrum, wide degree of what's out there as far as the consumer is concerned.
Right.
We don't have to worry about with the NAPA.
Not with the NAPA. You know, you're right, Randy. There are what we call local rebuilders. They would take a alternator or starter and put it on test bench, find out what's wrong with it, and just replace that one part. Give the alternator or starter back to you, and it will work just fine. However, they may have missed something in the commutator. They might have missed something in the brushes.
Might have been 90% worn out.
The brushes could have been. So you get a good price of that. But the chance of you breaking down at the most, there's no good place to have a breakdown. But when you do have a breakdown, it's...
Got you again.
Okay, I'll give you. Pennsylvania does have a lot of demands on their cars, particularly with the hills and the turns.
You ever drive in Pittsburgh?
No, I know. And I do live there, and I try not to drive in Pittsburgh because I swear PennDOT put asphalt on a cow trail, and they called it a road. but anyway, the... that's how a rebuilder, now a true remanufacturer, takes that core, and they do use pretty much the heart and the guts of the alternator and or starter. But the known worn parts are usually replaced with 100% new, like the brushes you mentioned. Every power alternator, every remanufactured Supreme alternator will have new brushes put in it and starters.
With a minimum of a 3-year, 36,000-mile warranty on the entry level quality. And believe me, folks, they're quality. And yeah, in some cases, if you know what goes on the inside of it, you're willing to pay an extra $10 or $15 because you know it's got the name NAPA on the box. And that means so much to the professional shops out there that primarily are the ones that buy this product because they don't want to do the job twice, especially if that alternator is buried somewhere in the middle of the engine.
Yes.
Or somewhere way down there where I can just barely make out that there's an alternator on there. No, we're not going to want to do that twice. So they almost insist on buying the NAPA premium products when they do a repair for that reason.
Correct.
For that reason. So we're going to come back with starters and conclude this with starters and a couple other little tips right after this. So do not go away. Hey, welcome back to Handy Randy Show. Our big sponsor, NAPA Auto Parts. And I should mention that there's a whole slew of NAPA Auto Care locations out in our community. There are NAPA parts stores in virtually every city in the United States and Canada, and now even in Mexico. Along with those parts stores, they have a whole fleet of NAPA Auto Care locations that carry this product, that have that same warranty as we mentioned, whether it be lifetime guarantee or 3-year guarantee. And all of those locations that we just spoke about have testing available where they can put this modern, it's called Medtronic tester, on the battery and be able to determine whether or not the battery needs replaced or just recharged.
Correct.
But they can instantly tell the consumer whether the starter, in this case, has got too much draw on it. And basically, that's what happens with starters, Tom.
Correct.
Right. And or alternators. They can do that same test and tell you within minutes whether the alternator is failing.
Yes.
The starter story is a little redundant because it's basically the same story as we just talked about on the alternators, correct?
Correct. Yeah. We want what we're trying to do at the garage level or the installer level is do a program called a test every vehicle, where we go in and talk to the installer, show him the Medtronic tester, and the ability to test not only the battery, but the alternator output and starter amp draw. And then the tester will determine if there's any issues. But most important, if there are no issues, this has a printer on it. The consumer gets a piece of paper printed with all the specifications on it. And if everything is fine, that tells the consumer that they're happy. They came in there for another expense, but they left knowing that their electrical system is good. And that means a lot to that consumer. And of course, if there's an issue with something, that should be brought to their attention too, because you don't want a breakdown. But our NAPA starter, like Randy said, was pretty much the same quality, same remanufacturing process that the alternators go through. And we still have lifetime warranty on this premium Power Supreme product. And again, the towing service is available. So when you folks are out looking for a good alternator or starter for your consumers, just just think of NAPA and our three different lines, new, power supreme, and just the power line for your requirements and your needs, because every one of those do meet the OE or exceed the OE specifications.
Speaking about that installer, that garage that's somewhere in your neighborhood, if for some reason you're working at one of those shops, whether you own the shop or you're a technician at one of those shops, and you don't have the capabilities in your shop to do that testing for your customer, to assure the customer that everything's okay, that you can give that readout to the customer. If for some reason your system is that antiquated, you need to contact your NAPA Auto Parts salesperson. He can bring Tom Hubbard right with him, right into that shop where you work. And we can show you this system, is how this system works, how you can supply your customers with the best in the industry starters, alternators, and batteries. And one other thing, something that's on the horizon, Tom, and this has been around, this technology has been around for a while, but it's more and more on automobile. Tell us about that.
Yeah, this is a grid, this is a plate out of a battery. It's called absorb glass mat. You can look at that and you can see it looks like the stuff that's in the baby's diaper, I'll call it. And that's the glass mat.
No. I've seen the stuff that's in the baby's diaper. That doesn't look anything like the stuff that's in the baby's diaper.
Okay.
It's made out of the stuff that's, okay.
It's
oh,
made,
I gotcha.
Thank you. It's made out of the stuff in a baby's diaper that's used to absorb the liquid that comes, that you use in this battery.
No liquid.
It's like a sponge, right? It absorbs the liquid. So there's no, like our old, like the battery we had up there, it has liquid in it, acid. And that, if you shake it, if you take the top off, it's gonna shake and bounce out. So spillage is a big issue in today's ecology and everything else that's, out there, where, we are trying to keep the environment clean, especially when we are this week, with the Save the Earth Week. But NAPA has, East Penn, has this new AGM absorbed glass mat battery that has a lot better features and benefits than the standard flooded lead acid battery. And one of the main things is that this battery, and we can show that.
The people out there might be familiar with the Optima battery that's been on the market for 10 years or so. Right. And that was used primarily, I think, on maybe
specialty.
High performance specialty,
that
cruising car, that collectible car. That's primarily what the consumer, race cars.
Correct.
Now that technology is available in the NAPA Legend battery, correct?
Correct. Yep, Randy, you're right. This battery was used and abused, and it held up because of this AGM design. It was just a tough battery that withstood vibration, has long shelf life, it holds amperage very well. And NAPA, because we do a lot of the automotive and also some of the specialty stuff, but the newer vehicles are coming out now with this AGM style design, square black box battery. So in order to get that battery to fit in the hold downs, East Penn is manufacturing this AGM design to fit in that battery, which will fit exactly in the correct hold down spot for the battery, whether it's under the hood, in the trunk, or under the seat, or who knows where.
Cutting edge technology, and that's one thing, again, that NAPA has always been famous for. They don't put that NAPA logo on just anything. It has to be tried, proven, then you can buy a product that you feel comfortable with, that's not going to fail you. Tom, thank you so much for coming on the Handy Randy Show.
Thank you.
Hope you learned something today. And again, there's a reason why I'm proud to say that NAPA Auto Parts is a sponsor of the Handy Randy Show for products like this, backed up with a team of experts like Tom Hubbard, even if he does come from Pennsylvania. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.
See you next time.